this actually goes down a block here. Look, oh my giddy aunt. We gotta be careful here, guys. We can open up what this was. Bollocks. Let's dig this out. I did want the double wall, didn't I? The double ramp wall all the way around, so. Yeah, no, we're okay. We'll be okay. Jesus. That my August stopped then, wasn't it? Was that die die I saw in chat? Hey, didn't die toy. That's the thing, huh? Grum, would you ever consider doing an underwater base build? Well, to be honest, mate, I'd love to, but Tony very much had that one wrapped up. And I think we've learnt a lot about building underwater. We've learnt that even being a merman is no guarantee of success. And we've also learnt that glass blocks are not very powerful. Oh my god, what the fuck is that? Oh my god! Is it? Oh god fucking Christ, I thought it was something really weird. It's a Daphne. Oh my god. I got a tingles down the back of my neck then. Fucking Christ, mate. Oh, I wonder what the fuck it was. I actually thought there was a ghost coming at me. That is so freaky. Son of a bitch. I just didn't click that I was playing a game with zombies just for that split second. I was completely just outside of my... Oh man, that was really weird. I was like proper running away. I was like, fuck, get out of here, dude, what is it? Oh, fuck. Oh, Jesus, that was fucking frightening, mate. Whoa, Christ, remind yourself you're playing a game, Grum. For God's sake, man. This is not real, dude. Oh, fucking Christ, dude. It looked like she was doing some fucking, like, this apparition, like, floating towards me. What the fuck? Get out of here, son! Get out! That's not normal, that ain't, mate. Oh, fucking hell. Oh, dear. Oh, God! Oh, that might have been a bad idea. Yeah, go on, get out! You're off my land! Farmer Grum, fuck off. Oh my god, he's got back up. Oh my god, where the fuck he got back up? Where the fuck, dude? There's that door, dude! You asshole! Fuck off. Is he dead yet? Oh god. I think I've been playing too much 7 Days to Die. I think I need to take a break, guys. I think we need to go and play something a little bit different. Oh my lord! God damn it, sir. Look at the state of this place. We're gonna need a mop. I think that's cool. Someone said that they didn't like this. I think that's kind of cool that they stand up and twitch like that for a little bit. It's pretty neat. Got the blood on him. I like the bit sticking out his neck, look. Oh dear. Oh, Jesus Christ, that's fucked the throat again. Wow. Yeah, that was a bit weird. I think we've become a little bit too absorbed by the game. What is that? Fucking lick it, mate. Run for your lives. I'm a very brave man, I'll have you know, in real life. Normally, I would have stood my ground and protected the innocent civilians of Grumbadia. He's got moobs, hasn't he, look? We should keep him, you know? We could have one of them outside the gates. A welcoming party. Oh, Jesus. Shocking, mate. Shocking. Right, okay, let's throw that in there. And that in there. Let's put sand back. Where's all the sand go? I've got too much sand. That's what happens when you dig in the desert, I suppose, isn't it, eh? Pull this back. God, I need a drink after that. Fucking hell. Shiver me timbers! Cheeky little Daphne. Plant fibers, fuel. Yeah, all right, we're good to go. I don't think I want to go out there. We should make some Grum curry. Look, we got... Oh, look, we can make 7 of them. Right, check this out, look. Grumbasco sauce. Very dangerous on its own. Don't eat that. Kill you, mate. This is Tindaloo quality, this is. Look at that. Isn't that gorgeous, mate? Grum equals the bravest. Oh, dear. Yeah, I think these are great. I think they're brilliant. Is there any chance you get to see them up close without sort of like, you know, pooping your pants, really? I tell you what, he does some leg work out, doesn't he? Look at the calves on this bad boy, man. He likes to work on the wheels, him. Right, he might actually have some Grumbasco. Get off my leg. Yeah. Grum curry, look. Eat. Ah, this stuff is quality food. Quality food. Rotting flesh and a turd and a bone. Right. I'm going to hit these bang on. I don't even know what I'm doing. Look, there you go. Rotting flesh. In there. Turd in there. See? I know my inventory system. Sort of. Let's go and repair this. Oh, right. Fortune, do you reckon we should do some spins? Are you there? Sand equals more concrete for wool. I know, I'm gonna have too much sand. It's weird. It's actually why we came out to the desert for concrete production, was to get the sand. And now I've got actually too much of it. I'm running low on stone, believe it or not. Alright. I don't know if Fortune's there. Oh, she is. Are you ready, my lady? Oh, that really hurt my voice, that did. Bloody hell. I'm going to pay for that later, I tell you. Right. Cues. Next up is Bomber. Good luck, Bomber. The wheel's been very fickle today. I think we had 3 losses earlier on. In a row, was it not? It's a Zunin. Next up is the one and only Schmeggy. Good luck, Schmeggy. Oh, sorry, did I not put the wheel up? Oh. It's alright, I'm a little bit terrified. I feel like something weird happened there. It was like a genuine terror running away from that ghost. I somehow couldn't quite separate the real world from the game. I think the fact that I've been up all night modding the server has put me in this weird state of consciousness. I'm sitting here like while the wheel's spinning, like desperately trying to claw back some semblance of sanity, to be quite honest. That was for Schmeggy. Next up is Sky. And Sky, this is the wonderful lady that does all the artwork for the channel and the Grum stars and everything. So thank you very much, Sky. Lack of sleep is not a good thing, is it? Quite funny, though. Oh, no. Come on. God. Sorry, Sky.
That is one big pile of shit.
We'll do one more. Gloom. Good luck, mate. Double zunning. Better than a pile of poop, innit? Just about, anyway. God, blimey, geezer. You've got a 5-sec delay now, Super Zoo. Oof. Jan said, "Poo for the wheel spin just started." Wow, there's some. So we were talking about it yesterday, weren't we? About like how erratic the delays are for different people. They know where the wheel's gonna stop. You can actually sort of guess it about 3-4 seconds before. You've probably got a pretty good idea where it's gonna land. So yeah, sometimes you are gonna get people that try and second guess it. It might not be as bad as it sounds, Super Zoo. I know I always try and sort of guess it. Right, do you want a quick, because we've got a bit of time to go. I really don't fancy going out there because we've got the forge running. I really don't want to upset another Daphne or whatever the hell that thing was. Let's, we'll do a little bit of roulette, all right? So don't forget, I'm only going to say this once, guys. So there's no coming back. There's you know, I've only just joined. I didn't know. It don't happen like that. When we do the roulette game, you can multi-bet. If your total of your bet on any one spin is more than 100 Grumbombs, so by all means, double bet like 50 on black, 50 on red, do whatever you want. But if you bet for a total of more than 100, we will remove your winnings and a percentage, and we'll just make that percentage up. It's normally around 10%. It might be 50. It depends on how I'm feeling. So don't do it, because you might lose fucking everything. No more than a total of 100 Grumbombs, all right? It will be obvious to everybody in chat, myself included, if you've done it. So just don't do it. A maximum of 100 Grumbombs per spin. You need a break. I might work on something else for a bit. I can't wrap your head around what Unity imports or doesn't. It imports the rigs and bones, but no constraints. It imports some textures, but not all of them. It might import animations, but only if baked. What the hell? Honestly, I really wish I could help you, mate. I really wish I could help you. When I link the videos, the YouTube videos, they're not the greatest in the world, but they certainly help me start to understand things a little bit, Sky, because obviously 5.3.3, it's not the latest version of Unity. So there were some things that you had to do in order to get them working for 7 days to die. So when I get a chance later on, I'll link you those. It might mean a lot more to you than it does to me anyway, Sky. But thanks ever so much for looking into it, mate. I hope we're not stressing you out. You're under no obligation, you know, Sky. It's your own fault for linking that bow, you see. Now everybody wants the Sky bow. I know I do. It looks amazing, mate. Right, let's get this bad boy set up then. Where are we finding roulette? Right, so that's roulette up and active. Got 2 minutes to place the bets. I'll probably run it a couple of times because evening is upon us. Let's see what we'll do. We'll get these bones for duct tape. Don't forget, do not bid more than a total of 100 Grumbombs. Or place a bet for more than 100 Grumbombs. Unity's a strange thing, isn't it, Sky? It is. It's a very strange thing. I've been watching lots and lots of tutorial videos on YouTube, and weirdly enough, none of them really got anything to do with what we're trying to do, but it has helped me start just getting a feel for what Unity really is, you know, how it differs from other engines and things. It's quite interesting. I, you know, just have it playing in the background sometimes while I'm modding the server, so a lot of it sort of goes in one ear and out the other, but... Where do we actually get to? Yeah, let's go and risk it for a biscuit. That Grum curry is insane, isn't it? It's nice to know that we can get active buffs working. The world is our oyster. I'm not fond of oysters. The world is our calamari rings. Maybe with a nice cold beer. What about that? That'd be nice, wouldn't it? Plate of calamari rings. Maybe a little bit of, I don't know, what do you reckon? A little bit of salad. Some nice little baby tomatoes, maybe. A bit of onion, a bit of lettuce. A couple of pints of lager. No, a couple of bottles. Sorry, what's that, Slade? Sorry, is it Slade? Are you new to the channel, Slade? How you doing, mate? Nice to meet you. Fuck you, dude. Fuck you. Have you made the cherry picker? No, I haven't, mate. But I mean, that's like a 30-second thing, mate. I mean, that really is like super easy. I mean, I suppose the hardest bit there is coming up with what we're going to use as the actual recipe, I suppose. How hard we want to make it. That just involves copying a block ID over and just tweaking a recipe, really. Careful. It would be something nice, you know, like if you're doing like a really big construction, so you can actually just have like 7 or 8 cherry pickers around it. I think it would really help people out. I would very much like to mod it in so it looks like a little bit more, I don't know, a little bit less than just a floating elevator. But again, it is way beyond me anyway. We'll get there. We'll get there. Don't forget, that's just going to keep going, guys. You can bet on... Oh, God, I wonder what that was. I'll keep it going until 4 o'clock in game, so... Oh, it's going to be needs repairs. It's all going to go in one big bang, isn't it? why is it not collapsing? There we go. I'd bloody love that. I think that's wicked. To the bloody temple. I've not done any of that over there yet. Oh my lord. How is this even standing? Bleeding out fire, mate. I've gone too far again, haven't I? Have I gone... You dickhead! Oh, fucking farts, mate. I have, haven't I? This is supposed to drop off here. I'm going to have to backfill all this with bloody... Oh, piss flaps, mate. Up to about what? There, do you reckon? You bloody dickhead, sir! You bloody dickhead! He's gonna encounter a Balrog. Oh, I can't believe I just did that again, man. I blank strike. We do need to dig down one, don't we? God, it's so complicated. The thing is, the sand's not very good, Sarks. The sand is, like, really expensive to actually make sand out of sand. It takes an incredibly long amount of time, and it's also, it's very, I think it's, like, 16 sand, like, to one normal sand. It's, like, crazy, dude. God, I'm out of fuel again. You do realise that this is basically about the worst thing I could possibly have done right now. Because right now, if a horde or something were to hit... Or let me stop that... let me stop the roulette thing. Ugh. What's that, Slade? Grumble, as a channel noob, can I ask if this is an extreme building game? Sorry, you haven't got enough grum bombs to ask a question, Slade. I did dig too deep, Super Z. Sorry, mate. Is this thing finished? Oh, it has, yes. So let's close that. The winner's come up. Yes, it has. Well, hang on, sorry, what's this fortune? What was that? Did Shmeggy... Has Shmeggy got a problem? What's up, Shmeggy? You're right, buddy. What's going down, bro? You're right, the Mike Stan. Yeah, that's a shame, isn't it? It's a shame. I'll tell you what we'll do. Let's get this little section here done. So we want to be digging in at this level. Let's get this cool thing down. So I'm probably not going to take it much further back. I mean, I think that's probably reasonable. I mean, the chances of... we'll sort of flatten it off. We don't want to lose the penis dial there. We'll just flatten off that edge. Maybe put a pit in there like we did on the other end. Right, William, how you doing, mate? Thank you very much for the follow, dude. That's going to be like really bad when that falls. I don't want to be underneath that when it does finally pop. So, Grim, it looks like you're a bit of a... First time I've played it, Slade. The first time I've been... a couple of hours in, mate. It's a bit of a weird game, to be honest. I'm not sure if I can stick it for much longer. It's been on for a couple of hours, mate. I think it's the sort of game I could put, you know, 800 hours into or anything like that. Look at that lot. Just all fucking hell. Right, I'll tell you what, let's very quickly make a chest. Stop it, Slade! Let's get rid of the rotting flesh. Crack the storage box. Quick, come on. Quick. What? I'm gonna hoover it all up. Probably lost a fair bit there, but... Popping it all over the place. You're having a laugh, mate. You're having a bloody giggle, sir. Is that all I got? 424? Yeah, I think we definitely lost a fair old whack there. I mean, this is pretty much going to be the corner here, isn't it? We don't need to go too much further back. Let's just even this corner out. Still need to go down one, don't I? Oh, you know what? This is the penis dial. Gotta be careful here, guys. Block off that there. What we'll do is we'll actually make the penis dial like legit, and we'll actually like add some letters and stuff to it because we can't make numbers. So let's leave that well alone. Where's Schmeggy gone? Well, you know an ex-girlfriend's name, Schmeggy. It's all got... Oh, Schmeggy, you've donated, but it's not come up, mate. I'm so sorry, dude. That stinks, mate. I'll tell you what, let me just check Grumbot, mate. Let's tell you what, hang on. One sec, dude. I saw you say something earlier about does it take some time to come up. I didn't know you'd actually donated. It's definitely not coming up my end, dude. There's nothing on Grumbot. What I'll do is, Schmeggy, I will check PayPal later, mate. and obviously, we can transfer grum bombs and do all that. So don't worry, you won't miss out, Schmeggy. More importantly, mate, all that aside, thank you very, very much, mate. Even for thinking about it, if it's not even gone through, dude. Thank you very, very much, dude. We've had it happen, I think it happened once before. I can't remember who it was. It's got nothing to do with the roulette or anything like that. I mean, if it was 45 minutes ago, I can only think it's just not run through with Grumbot. Now, the last time it happened and I asked them about it, they actually told me that Grumbot, Deepbot servers were actually under a DDoS attack. So, to be honest, I kind of believed it because it was the first time, you know, I'd ever seen a donation not go through. I'm going to be honest, something about it just smelt a little bit like an excuse, so... Oh my god! Oh no! Oh dude! Oh dude!
54 minutes, 37 seconds.
Oh, that's
not
good. That's not good. Oh fuck. Oh my god, the whole... Oh my lordy lord. That's not normal. Oh, you bugger. Now that is a tear, guys. Oh my god, look at it. Holy shit. That is like a fucking star destroyer, that is, mate. You walk up here, that's cool. What could possibly go wrong, right? Walking up a tear in the world. Yeah, I think it was you. It was you, wasn't it, Mojo? Yeah, good point, mate. Good point. Hello, Nathan. How you doing, mate? Schmeg it, honestly, dude. I really wish. Yeah, I'm so sorry that hasn't happened. But we'll do a thorough fanfare once it's all resolved, mate. Thank you once again. Really appreciate that. What's that, Meerkat? You're off to play some 7 days. Don't forget about Meerkat Summer Fruit Salad. I won't, honestly, mate. Oh, hang on. Boiled berries in a can. Boiled berries. What, like blueberries? We're going to have some natural gas involved here. You do know that, Meerkat, don't you? We're going to have to bottle up some turds, get the natural gas, and add it to the Meerkat Summer Fruit Soda. You've given me an idea, mate. Now, mate. Is it an alcoholic one? You donated £1,000, but it never arrived with good. It didn't, mate. No, I don't know what you're on about, mate. Can't remember what happened to that. Oh, you'll have to just do it again, mate. Just double check it's working properly. Right, I am gonna switch to the old trusty shovel for a moment, and we're just gonna have a little look at what we do here. Right, so that was the block location, so let's backfill. We need to get rid of this one. This one's a nasty critter. This is a dastardly tear. You still see it, look, underneath it. It's weird, isn't it? Alright, at least we've got an angle on him.
Hello?
So, if we take it... Let's have a look. There's a fine art to getting rid of these buggers. Might have risked that a little bit too close there. I reckon if we fully fill in all of that, we've got half a chance. Ooh, that's a little bit close to Bear Balls Oasis for my liking, boys and girls. No alcohol. So it's a non-alcoholic summer fruit soda. All right, Meerkat. We'll sort it out, mate. Don't you worry. Is there any particular preference in terms of colour? I mean, the only berries in the game are... blueberries. Let me have a think. Wooden frames. Let's make 100. Those! The things you have to do in this game, right, to build stuff. It's not just a case of sticking a couple of blocks down, is it? Tears in the space-time continuum. A ready orange. Okay, I can work with that, mate. We'll have to have some tomatoes in there, I reckon, mate. I'm not sure about how we're going to do the berries, though. As long as you get a start and exit, normally crush it without having to backfill. It's a little bit optimistic. Oh, we might have got rid of it. We might have done it, actually. No, if we can't get one of these blocks in. That was a big one. That's the biggest I've ever seen. This is what I'm sure. Using the auger in sand, I think what happens is the server just it can't keep up with the data that's. Well, I don't think it's the case of the server. I actually sometimes think it's the client, to be honest. What do you reckon? That seems to have sort of squished it, doesn't it? Someone's going to come across here. What the fucking hell's he building, mate? It's nothing. It's literally nothing. There's some free wooden blocks if anybody wants any on the server. Mixing some golden rod. Yellow and blue makes orange. If only it was that simple, right? You probably ended up in someone's curry fun mojo. Oh, that's where it all goes, mate. Let's, that is the right level, isn't it? So let's just see if we can go back along here. I'm really sorry about it, Shmeggy. That sucks, mate. I'm really, really apologetic. I promise I'll sort it out, dude. Like, it was definitely yours, wasn't it, Mojo? The last one. It's the only other time I can ever think of that happening. Maybe I should give them the benefit of the doubt. Kind of like a Fanta fruit twist. Fucking hell, mate! Jesus Christ, not too specific, yeah? I'll sort it out, Meerkat. So you want it bubbly and you want it red and orange, yeah? I'm just going to make a note, right? Bubbly. Red, orange. What we'll do is we'll have it as a buff that's like a really good thirst quencher. Not a nice little stamina boost. What about cooling? We'll add cooling to it. Yeah, that's a nice idea, Nick. So we'll add it with the same buff as, is it goldenrod tea? Is that always, no, the red tea, the chrysanthemum one. I think that's a cooling one, isn't it? Or yucca, maybe? Yeah, I've got plans for you, mate. Yellow and blue makes green. Is it? Yellow and blue makes... Yeah, it does, doesn't it? Yeah. Blue and red makes purple. Yeah, I'm with you so far. So good luck getting orange from blue. That was a big test, like, honestly, mate. It was kind of weird, that one. It looked like it was just there, but it actually went all the way across here as well. Really weird. Not seen one like that. A bit spooky, actually. Don't want any more like that. Oh, no, sir. No. Stay still. Right, am I on the right level? Stripe! Get your calipers out, mate. Do you reckon if I just tunnel, right, and all the way underneath there, and then dig it from the other side? I'm about to have 3,000 tons of fucking desert sand land on my head. Oh my god, what's that? Oh my lord. Look at this. How would that even happen? Oh my god. Oh, I don't like that. Let's get out of here, mate. You can add in some poop for a nut extract. Oh dear god. I could always add in, I mean, what were we talking about earlier? We decided against cannabis, so I think we were going to go tobacco leaves, weren't we? So we get the cigar. I mean, the cigars are ready today, so. I wonder what buffs that actually gives. Obviously, I've never actually, like used it as such. Assuming it was, can you remember? Did it replace the bandana? It's an equipable, asset, essentially, wasn't it? It's an equipable item. I think that's a good length down there. You can't mix any of this anyway, guys. You can't mod it like that. That's not the way it works. It's a completely moot point anyway. Now and again, I'm on the right level. That's incredibly helpful, Scry. Thank you, mate. I should hire you permanently. You fucker. 1,000 grum bombs. You know what this means, Fortune? What was that? Oh, no, right, I'll giggle with this today. I think it's the stress release of knowing the server's working. Now we're about to kill it by doing all this. Why is that not collapsing? Come on. Come on. There she blows, Captain. There she blows. Really? Gotta be this bit here, isn't it? Cheeky. One little sand block too many somewhere. I ain't going in there. Absolutely no chance, mate. You right, Masters? How you doing, dude? Thank you for the follow. That is shocking, guys. That is shocking. My god, really? What's that, Naga? In what server am I playing? We're playing on a private server, mate. This is our own server. Our own modded server. Full of juicy goodness and curries and meerkats and fruit. You're right, the goat. How you doing, buddy? I'm really struggling to believe this is staying up. I'm also slightly worried that when it goes, too much is going to go in one go. It's going to freak the chunk out. Oh, flip a duck, mate. I need repair kits. Damn it, this is getting expensive. Thing is, we've got to do this a bit sharpish, otherwise, even a tier 1 horde, get the wrong zombie in the wrong sort of corner. Start causing a bit of damage, couldn't it? You're right, Goliath, how you doing, dude? How did the stream and everything go, buddy? I do apologise, mate. I was very, very busy trying to save our server last night, dude, so I didn't get a chance to come and say hello or anything. How did it all go? Did you have fun? Is it tear testing? I think there's a very good chance it's going to end up like that, mate. Weird to think that we've been there for so long. Oh god, look how... Oh my god, that's what... Oh my god, I actually thought I was about 8 blocks away from this. Oh my god, it's all the way over there. Dude, it's huge. Which daft prat decided to do this then? We should literally just have a day where we just let everybody on the server just whitelist like 20 people. And they can all just jump on it and just help us do this. You're right, sausage. How are you, mate? How's things? Hang on. Too deep. You know what I'm going to do? I'm going to put blocks in here. So, this one actually does need backfilling. Let's do this now. Wooden frames. Let's make another 100 of those. I'll tell you what, I've never terraformed before on this scale, ever. Not in all the times I've played it. It's, this is quite some project, actually. So all of this essentially will need backfilling, won't it? No, it's not that bad. I mean, we don't have to do every single block, because the flagstone's pretty good on the structure integrity, isn't it? What we'll try and do is get this area done so it's kind of neatened up a little bit.
Hello?
You're right, Starform. Thank you very much for the follow, mate. How are you? The thing is, because I've had so little sleep, I wouldn't dare do anything more complicated anyway, guys, to be fair. If it involved any mental arithmetic, I mean, look, this just literally involves me, like, digging the right horizontal, well, I suppose the right vertical level, and look what's happening. Imagine trying to build a 56 block high sphinx. Yeah, that's going to go well, isn't it? It'll look more like a fucking worm. And that's if we were lucky. What is it, Grum? It's a sphinx, mate. It looks a little bit like a testicle. It's a testicle sphinx, sir. We'll role play out of it, don't worry. You just got off work, you figured you'd catch a little bit of the old shenanigans. Oh, thanks, sausage. What time is it there then, dude? So this is all flagstone. So that's done. So that's okay. So at that point you drop down to, at this point we're still only one high. Let's see if we can get this all the way back to that big tear that we've got. Did you get some sleep yesterday? Yeah, no, I'm not sleeping. Yeah, you were really struggling, weren't you, mate? You'd, what were you down to, like, 5 hours in, like, 48 hours? That's pretty bad, dude. What did you do differently, Jan? Was it just one of those things where you just happened to get a good night, or...? Is there a... Oh, look, guys, it's going, look. Excellent. You know what, when I was saying about the surf guy, this is essentially, imagine this, right? So you can sort of see like the chunks like going absolutely crazy. This is essentially what's going on in Tony's chunk. I mean, obviously I've got no way of knowing what the data actually is, but it was just like, it was like the CPU sort of load was just like absolutely insane over there. So something was going on, and I dread to think what it was. I really need Tony to go and have a look at it at some point. Let me know if me poking about with it has actually like destroyed anything. See, what could have happened is because Tony was getting that those weird blocks, which I don't think was a server issue. At least I don't think it was. It might be one of those cases where stuff was there for Tony but wasn't there on the server. I mean, I just don't know. I need to have a chat to find out exactly what's happening. I mean, at the moment, all I know is he had a horrendous collapse due to the water sort of essentially imploding his glass blocks, wasn't it? You know what, I love Twitch, how you doing? It's 8 o'clock. Oh, you work the 12-hour graveyard shift. Fucking hell, mate. See you later, Mo fan. To be careful here, because that is essentially where we're going to drop down now, isn't it? So that's far off, actually, is it, really? What were you streaming live? Was it 7 days tonight, wasn't it, mate? I suppose if you're going to terraform, you might as well do it in the desert, right? Can't go wrong with the old auger. I'm dreading moving all this stuff out of here. That in itself is going to take a little bit of time, isn't it? Alright, so that is where we drop down a block. Everything beyond this point actually drops down an additional one. So I think what I'm going to do... Shall we flagstone up? Let's go and have a quick look at what this is looking like over here. And this is nearly done, isn't it? Nearly done, fuckers like, mate. Oh my god. 5.5 hours real life until a tier one horde. Yeah. See, the problem I've got is, if a horde, for example, was to come in from this direction, they're going to drop in here, start smashing through blocks, they're going to start tunneling underneath this. I can't afford for this not to be backfilled by the time the next horde hits. So, I mean, it might look like we've got all the time in the world and this doesn't really matter a jot, but if the horde comes in at the wrong angle, this could be catastrophic. Like, really bad. In fact, I don't even know where to begin right now, guys. I really don't. See, even if I... Oh, I suppose as long as we're there, the horde will come towards it, won't it? So there's no danger of them digging through that underneath the temple. Fuck. Fuck. Fuck, 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 fuck. That is where we need to be, yeah? It's actually one block out, to be honest. But... Yeah, I'm just going to tidy this corner up first, right? And then I'm going to go nip back inside. I'm going to start making some of those angled flagstone blocks, mate. See, what would be really nice, we could actually, if we were really clever and really lucky, I could actually backfill, dig this out, and if the horde was to come over here, they'd fall into the pit and actually knock this out for us. So it's almost worth me trying. In fact, should we even try that? That might not be a bad idea, guys. Do we actually do some zombie tunneling? Let me just show you what I'm thinking. Oh, I've got no freaking frames. Oh, my God. Wooden frames. Barely. Yeah, I mean, this whole area needs to be knocked out, doesn't it? So if I was to... Really? If I could get some zombies to fall down here, they would literally bury underneath all of this, wouldn't they? You're right, Fata. Protect the main compound first, Grim. You don't want the Z tunnels there at any cost. No, we don't. Do you reckon mods will come to console? I wouldn't have thought so, Atomic Boom. I'd be very surprised, mate. I'd be very, very surprised. The modding sort of scene at the moment isn't, if you like, officially supported anyway by the dev team. They love to see it, and they're not going to stop it. But in their own words, you know, they're not worried about upsetting modders by, you know, changing game, you know, core game code. So as much as Mad Mole and everyone loves the mods, you know, thinks it's incredible that the community kind of get behind it in that sense, I'd be very, very surprised if mods are officially supported before release. And release is a long, long, long way away, mate. Twitch doozy. Get out. Bad, not bad. It's actually quite cool doing this, like flagging them and collapse. Quite good fun. Trying not to get squashed is a really important element here. Oh, God's sake, this thing is just getting muddled. It's costing me a fortune, guys. It is actually costing me a fortune. Look at that oil. Still going, look. Look at that little bugger. Nah, the difference is with Bethesda and the Xbox guys, and I suppose to some point PlayStation 4, if it ever happens, you've got a game engine that was always very heavily supported via modding. So if you think about the mods that are done for, you know, like PlayStation 4, Xbox One, if we're going to talk about Bethesda in particular with Fallout 4, and they actually have like a creation kit. They have something, in other words, a landscape, a self-contained sort of modding environment that modders can use to create mods. A game like this isn't even finished yet, so there is no way they're going to allow mods on something like this, which is going to constantly be breaking every time there's an update. Even once the game is released, and we're hoping that'll be like at some point in 2017, because don't forget it's still in alpha. They were hoping to have final release, in other words, for the game to go gold in December of this year, but that's now been put back to 2017. Even then, for a game like this to enable mod support would involve a huge amount of work by the dev team. It's far more complicated than you realize modding the game. If you've never done it, I mean, if you have done it, then you know just how complicated it is and what the devs would be up against. One of the biggest issues you've got, of course, is that it's an enclosed ecosystem with the Xbox One and Microsoft's sort of Xbox Live. They are very, very worried about mods essentially being able to access deep if you like, what are they called? The API routines within the console itself. So, for example, you could actually get someone that could potentially mod a game and actually have it doing things with the Xbox that it really shouldn't be doing, like burning your fucking house down. So the whole scene around modding is very, very, very tightly sort of encapsulated. And it's really impressive that Bethesda and Microsoft have worked so closely to get mods into Fallout 4. With a game like this, you are going to be looking at years. We're already looking at like 12 months away, I would have thought a final release on console. I know they've sold it as a completed product, but let's be honest, it's still in alpha actually on the PC. So I'd say 18 months away before the game's even, you know, completely 100% stable. They're happy with it. All the updates have been done and they go, right, now's the point where we might start looking at a creation kit equivalent for modders to use. I was actually very impressed that Bethesda and Microsoft managed to work so well together. I was super impressed when those Fallout 4 mods started popping up. And let's be honest, you've got to be very careful with those. I mean, we know how many people have been moaning that those have broken their game and their saves no longer work. I think it's a headache that is very unlikely to happen. Does this game have online like Rust or co-op? Yes, it does, my game. This is a server, dude, so this is a multiplayer server. Oh, you fix the game. You basically modify the 7 Days to Die files to register in the game. But I want it to run at unlimited time without crashing or closing down, because it was, for some reason, was running at 10 seconds before it crashes or closes at 64-bit and 14 seconds on 32-bit before it crashes. You had to modify the 7 Days to Die files to register in the game. What the hell, SheMine? You actually had to do that? Oh my god, well, at least you got it working. I mean, that's fantastic news, Shuman. Congratulations. That's shocking, mate. That's shocking. I wouldn't even know how to do what you just said that you did, mate. So, congratulations and well done. Now you can get on with playing it. This is where you find out you don't like it, Shuman. You play it for half an hour, get eaten by a dog and go, yeah, fuck that. Back to League of Legends. I'm out of bloody fuel. Oh, I was just sitting here thinking, why is it not working? What's that, Fortune? What's that little thing? I don't even know what that little emote even means, mate. You're like Barry Fish. How you doing, stranger? Yeah, I mean, you know, like I said, I think it's very, very unlikely you're going to see mods coming to this on console. But let's hope it happens at some point. It would be very nice, wouldn't it? Ordinary talent, how you doing, mate? Nearly time for a coffee break, what do you reckon, guys? Let's see if we can get this corner done. Might be pushing my luck here, this is a very deep drop on this one. Walk away, Sky. Walk away, mate. I had to do it last night, Sky. Honestly, I was just in so much distress at one point. I was literally just looking at the same lines of code over and over and over and over and over, Sky. And I honestly actually started feeling like almost physically ill over it. It was just terrible, mate. Just literally get up, turn it off, leave it. I know how you feel, mate. I was just going around in circles. I really was. You know the strange thing? When I don't actually set it up and then come back to it, started figuring stuff out that actually wasn't a problem. So I was actually picking up on things that weren't an issue before. So I started fixing things that I didn't even know were that weren't even broken, or I didn't know they were broken. But I still couldn't solve the actual issue with the server. So it just goes to show, doesn't it, when you walk away, you do pick up on different things. Quite a pain in the ass that you had to modify the game files to actually register the time you wanted it to play before it crashed. I can't even begin to understand that, man. That's just bonkers, isn't it? That's just crazy. Am I going to play No Man's Sky? It's still up in the air, mate. Honestly, I really don't know. Had a bit of a breakthrough. I hope you can hear me, by the way, while this org is going. I know it's not. I was, excuse me. I was all for No Man's Sky. But we've had a bit of a breakthrough on this, sort of in the last 24 hours. I can now get to a point where I can mod this a little bit more efficiently than I was. That's on. So there's a lot of things that I would like to start doing on this game now, mate. I mean, I will play No Man's Sky. There is no doubt about that. I will certainly get it at some point. At the moment, I think, there's that many people playing it. I'm not sure if it might be nice for me to just go and use that as a channel myself to watch on Twitch, actually watch someone else play something for a little bit. Quite intrigued by No Man's Sky, mate. I like my exploration and sort of steady progression in games. I like the thought of upgrading a flight suit and a spaceship and travelling ever deeper into the universe. Might be quite nice to just watch somebody else play something like that. We can sit back, chill out. I don't know, mate. I don't know. I think the problem I have, to be quite honest, is it Cal Kyle? Well, once I start playing another game, I always find it really hard to go back to the game I was playing before. It's very much what happened with 7 Days to Die, and I'm having so much fun with 7 Days to Die, that playing No Man's Sky would be really bad for me. At the moment, I'm just about at that point where I'm comfortable playing about with the game files. And I'm always the same with Skyrim, mate. I can spend like a couple of months playing about with Skyrim mods before I actually even boot the game up to play properly. And if you take a break, it's really hard to get back into it, mate. It's really, really difficult. You start making all the silly little mistakes that you used to make in the first place. And of course, we've got Alpha 15, could drop at any point. So there's something else I've got to take into account. When Alpha 15 hits, I really want to be primed and ready. I don't know, mate. It's a tough call. It doesn't come out until Friday on the PC anyway, so I've got a bit of time to mull it over. Is it the most streamed? Is it? It doesn't surprise me in the slightest, mate. The hype has been pretty insane for it, hasn't it? I mean, I like what I've seen. I really do, I don't think it's a game I'll purchase and hate. Oh my god, is the box all the way over here? I thought I'd lost my box. I was looking on there. Wow. That repair kit. It's almost worth me, making a cement mixer over here so I don't actually have to move all these. As daft as it sounds, it'd probably be more efficient, wouldn't it? Thanks, Sausage. Take care. Thanks for joining us, mate. Cryptic Tundra, you've just ordered No Man's Sky. I hope it's worth it. I hope you enjoy it, mate. Hello, Johnny. What are you eating, dude? You're actually trying to get away from League of Legends, are you? I had no idea you played League of Legends, mate. I suppose the statistics were in my favour on that comment, right? Have we got any repair kits? I've got one left. Oh, Jesus. Let's go get some fuel as well. We might as well finish this side off. Bloody hell, I'm glad when it's done, I tell you. It's the noise of the auger. I want some fucking peace and quiet, to be quite honest with you. But, oh, God, I'm running out of fuel as well. You watched about 15 minutes of No Man's Sky today and you ended up getting annoyed at all of them, unfortunately, so I concluded the game. Yeah, you must play yourself and you can't watch. Yeah. So when does Alpha 15 drop? We just don't know. We just don't know, Jaguar. It could be in a couple of 3 weeks. It could be 3 months, mate. Is there any way to turn down the game volume a little bit? I can, yeah. Do you want me to turn it down while we're doing this? Yeah, just shout out if you want me to do that. Let's drop it down to 25 while we do the auger. Does that actually do anything? God damn it, yeah. What you got from Greggs, dude? I like my Greggs, mate. Any advice for building underground early on when you don't have concrete? Not really, mate. I suppose the best thing is you need to have the top of your area. That's still fucking loud, isn't it? You need to have the top of your bunker very much protected. So I would suggest maybe using spikes. I mean, when I lived in Bunker Bob, before we got all the perimeter defences up in Caliper City, what I did was basically where the bunker existed underground, immediately over the living area or the area where I would stand when the horde hit, I put an absolute shit ton of spikes. So the zombies essentially would come to a point directly above me and then would start obviously sort of deciding what they were going to do, whether it was digging down or wandering around being a bit worried about, you know, the AI routines going zappo. And in the end, it worked out quite well. They tended to just clamber around on the spikes, killing themselves. It worked in my favour, to be fair. So yeah, I mean, if I'm living in a bunker down in that hole, this whole area here I would just surround in spikes. And obviously to get into the base, just have, say, maybe a hatch with a ladder down. And in order for you to get over the spikes, just use blocks. So if that's a spike, just put blocks over it and just jump up and go in that way. That's probably the best way to do it, I would have thought. I'm not a big fan of living underground, to be honest, mate. I only ended up staying in Bunker Bob because someone told me it was a very, very, very bad idea and it had ended extremely badly for them. So I thought, well, there's a nice little challenge. It turned out to be the start of Caliper City, is it? It turned out. Let me just get this corner done. So close now, guys. I might not even have enough repair kits, so. And as